Please rise. We begin the sacred Triduum in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May our Lord be with you. How good it is for us to be able to gather, perhaps in limited number and scope, but to celebrate finally after a year absence, the great feast of the core of our faith, the Triduum that brings us to Easter Sunday. One long, long day of prayer, one long day of sacrament and sacrifice. Let us all call to mind our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
To people of goodwill, we praise you.
Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, a banquet of his love. So grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it, with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate, with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Before the feast of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing, you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only wash my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all. For he knew who would betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at the table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that, as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord's Supper, the Last Supper, is one of the most famous paintings in the world. There are different versions of this painting, but Leonardo da Vinci's is about the most famous. It took da Vinci about 3 years to complete his painting, and like any other piece of art, this painting has been subject to different interpretations. There exists a legend about the painting. Leonardo too had great strides in capturing the essence of each of the apostles for the painting over the period of 3 years. Leonardo saved the last character of the painting for Judas Iscariot, who betrayed Jesus unto death for Jesus and himself. He tried to paint many different men, but was not satisfied with the results. One day, a raggedy, sinister-looking person applied for the painting of Judas. Leonardo had finally found his sublime character, even though the man was younger but seemed aged. In conversation during the painting, the man asked Leonardo if he was acquainted with him. The painter said no. The young man, who had fallen into disarray, said, "Master Leonardo, don't you remember me?" Leonardo said, "No. Should I?" The man said, "I posed for the picture of Christ 3 years ago when you started your painting." Leonardo was dreadfully surprised. The man said that he had eventually fallen away from the church and began a life of self-indulgence. Now he was broke and nobody wanted anything to do with him. That is why he applied for the person of Judas. He felt well equipped for representing the betrayer in the painting. How the mighty and the great have fallen because of sin and selfishness. He had lost everything, possibly even his soul, to Satan. Perhaps this painting and the reunion with Master Leonardo would be a salvation for him and the beginning of a new life in Christ. For the Lord feeds us with the bread of heaven and the wine of his own blood at the Last Supper and at every Mass we celebrate until the end of time. However, what is most important is that the event of the Last Supper shows a very significant event in the life of Jesus himself. It was a farewell meal, which he shared with his disciples in the upper room. The significance that the Last Supper of Jesus took place during the celebration of the Israelite Passover. Thus, the Lord's Supper indicates that Jesus replaces the blood of the sacrificial lamb with his own blood, which is poured out for the salvation of many. The event of the Lord's Supper also presents Jesus as the new Moses, the lawgiver, and Melchizedek, the high priest, when Jesus said, "Do this in memory of me." He ordained them the first priests of the new covenant to be sealed by his death on the cross. Holy Thursday is also known as Maundy Thursday because during the celebration of the Last Supper, Jesus gives a new mandate to his followers. Maundy, a short form of the Latin mandatum, mandate, which is taken from the Gospel of John. Mandatum novum da vobis de diligatis. In vicem sicut delexi vos, a new commandment I give you, that you love one another as I have loved you. Jesus translated this new mandate into action when he rose from the supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. Jesus did the unusual on the day of his special supper with his disciples. He washed the feet of Judas, who betrayed him. He also washed the feet of Peter, who denied him. He stooped to wash the feet of the rest of the apostles who fled and deserted him when he was arrested. This gesture of Jesus teaches that those who believe in him should serve not only family and friends, but should also serve those who oppose and betray them. Holy Thursday sets the stage for Good Friday. After the Last Supper, Jesus spent the night in prayer, and at that crucial moment, his disciples were too weak to accompany him on his night of struggle. He asked his disciples in a voice full of anguish, "So, you couldn't stay awake with me for 1 hour?" This is why parishes organize adoration on the night to provide an opportunity for people to spend some time in prayer in front of the Blessed Sacrament in preparation for Good Friday. So on behalf of Father Edwards, Deacon Joseph, Sister Teresa Mary, our sacristan Gerard, and myself, may this evening be spent in a holy awe and prayer to bring blessings to you and every household in the parish of Mary, Mother of God. Amen.
Typically at this time, we have the beautiful ceremonial washing of feet, but we can't have that. We do have the bowl and the urine basin here and the towel. Just ask you to take a minute or two now in place of the action to pray for your priest. Pray for your priest to be holier priest, and pray for more priests in place of the washing of the feet, which symbolizes the institution of the priesthood. Let us rise and offer our intercessions to the Lord.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That Christ, the high priest, guide all believers in the path of self-sacrifice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ, the suffering servant, inspire public servants to do more for those in need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all peoples come to know and acknowledge Jesus as Savior in the breaking of the bread. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Mary, Mother of God family, may our love for Jesus be evident in our reverence and adoration of the Lord present in the Holy Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill or experiencing suffering of any kind, find healing, consolation, and peace through the reception of the Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who died, especially Wayne Rodney, for whom this Mass is offered, may they offer rejoice at the heavenly banquet for all eternity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us end the petitions by praying the vision prayer, which can be found on the yellow cards in the pew.
Jesus, we are your people. We praise you as Savior and Lord. Deepen our commitment to you, your church, and each other. Let us all share more actively in spreading the good news of God present among us. Help us reach out to those who have not yet experienced the joy of participating in parish life. Inspire us to seek justice and peace for all members of our parish family and beyond. Assist us in living your gospel of compassion and love in service to those in need. Mindful of our many blessings, we are especially grateful for your gift of our parish family, a family dedicated to Mary, Mother of God, her spouse, Joseph, and our beloved saints, Anthony, Vincent, Stanislaus, and Stephen. Lord, send us your spirit. Make us alive as we have never been. Let us celebrate together and place our hope in you. Amen. Please be seated, my friends. Now, as you know, the liturgy committee spends hours planning the usual procession that we have here on Holy Thursday night, but not tonight. Tonight we're simply going to have the three oils brought forward. The deacon and I will have the jobs of introducing them, shall we say. You should know what they are. They were blessed by the bishop just on Tuesday at the cathedral. So I'm sure the procession is ready. Lion, Deacon Joe, if you can get ready for your job to give a brief description of each of the oils. First, we have the most important of the oils, which is consecrated by the bishop. I cannot bless this oil, the sacred chrism, carried forward by Mary Ann Beeley.
This oil will be used in all baptisms, and in a special way this year, will be used in the sacrament of confirmation for our young people in May.
The oil of the sick, carried forward by Jennifer Pitts.
This oil will be used in countless anointings of the sick, especially at allied services and our local hospitals.
Finally, the third oil, the oil of catechumens, carried by Alice Naughton.
This oil will be used in baptisms here at Mary, Mother of God Parish.
Thank you. Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh sacrificed for us, we are made strong. As we drink his blood poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels, archangels, thrones, dominions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we praise you as we say, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her, to guard her, to unite her, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants and all who are gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and for all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and the hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially with the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God, our Lord Jesus Christ and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, all the saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe that day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, for our salvation, the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, And once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you, for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, his glorious ascension into heaven, of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to you, glorious majesty, from the gifts you've given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, the holy and spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through our participation at your altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son and be filled with every grace and blessing.
Remember also all our servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and now rest in the peace of Christ. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us also, your servants, those sinners, hope in your abundant mercy, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all the saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, Lord. Sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, bestow them upon us. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Together we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from ever evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace to the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares the feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Come share the supper of the Lord. This is the bread of God, coming down from heaven, giving life to us, to all the world. Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Hear the Lord prepares the feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Come share. Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Hear the Lord prepare.
Our very short procession to the tabernacle will close this ceremony. If you wish to stay to pray, as I said, we'll be open till 9 or on live stream till 9. If you choose to leave, please leave in perfect silence.